Do I look good or what?
Seriously. You look like Sutton. You look really good tonight. Happy New Year.
All right. Now, we're going to talk about Johnny Bauer.
Well, you want to do that first? Because there is a game in Ottawa that you were a little ticked off at.
No, let's do Johnny Bauer first. We have to do Johnny Bauer first.
That's great.
Everybody talks about Johnny Bauer. You know, they know him now in the Leafs. I knew him when he played for Providence. In fact, my rookie year, I played against him in Providence. Then he went to Cleveland. And I'm going on to tell the guy that nobody mentions is Punch Imlach. Punch Imlach. Look how he signs his name. You can read it. Listen, Punch Imlach, when I played for him in Springfield with Punch, he saw Johnny when he played for Cleveland. The first thing he did when he got to Toronto, he was interleague drafted. They didn't need him. He couldn't make New York because Charlie Rayner was there, Gump was there, and Charlie Rayner was Prince Charlie, and he buried for 11 years. You think he was good at 32? You should have seen him when he was about 26. He was dynamite. He's a good guy. He's a gentleman just like Danny Galvin, Dick Irvin, eh?
And Jean Beliveau, who said you could not deke Johnny. Would not bite
a pork chick.
Yeah, for sure. All right. So Celebration of Life show, you're on it this Wednesday at 2:30 Eastern. I'll mention that one more time on Sportsnet. So here's a little penalty.
Now, look, folks, I go along with penalties, and I don't want to bite the hand that's feeding me, but you've lost 10, 15 in a row. You call that a slash. Now, I don't blame, I know how he feels. He gets up, he works hard all day. Now he's down 1-0, they score on that. I mean, you can't coach when you do that stuff. That is not a penalty. I don't care what anybody says, that's not a penalty.
Stick above the waist on the gloves. I mean, it's close enough.
Come on!
They call him all the time. It's terrible, I know. But
all right, let's go.
Here's a moment in time. 1981, Wayne Gretzky. So 50 was the standard, right? Yep. And to imagine, he's sitting 5 goals shy of 50 in his 39th game of the year. Said he couldn't shoot. Said he couldn't do anything on breakaways. There's another one. So that's 3 in the game. Here's his 4th in the game. This is his 39th game of the year. If he gets one more, he's got 50. And this is the one more.
Watch Barber.
He's moving in. He's gone!
Tim Dancy and you, listen.
50 goals in 39 games. He's got 50 goals before anybody else got 30.
There you are.
They sound just the same. And I'm going to get a funny story to tell you. I don't have much time, but I'm going to tell you anyhow. I'm walking out with Billy Barber after, and he is just furious like this. And I said, now watch him fall down. He says, all people remember 20 years from now is me falling down. I'm telling you, 30 years from now, and Billy, if you're watching like that, I got to bring it up again. He fell down on an open net. Anyhow, Billy, he was just swearing. Anyhow, let's go.
Don, you went out to Swift Current for the memorial service. This is a sad one. This is the anniversary as well, December 30th, of the bus crash for the Swift Current Broncos of the WHL. And there's a beautiful shot of the team, and we have the 4 men who perished in this accident. And this time of the year, when teams are traveling all across Canada in the toughest weather, here are the 4 guys, Don.
Yeah, they were the tough guys. They were sitting in the back. Fred Kreisky, isn't he a good-looking boy? I'll tell you, they're all good guys. I know people, Scott Kruger, they were all the tough guys sitting together playing cards at the back, and they had a big window, and the window fell out when they crashed, and they went underneath it. I mean, they're just, and that's Lindy's brother right there. If Lindy's watching right now, I know he's a little upset, but I know that those guys would be happy to be on Coach's Corner and showing their picture. I know they would. They were 2 great guys.
Just what you're saying there about the tough guys. Cody Eakin plays for Vegas now, will be on Rogers tomorrow. And his hero, Zach Smith, who's hurt right now, but for the honest, 2 tough guys, right? The 2 spirited guys.
Yeah, and they all hang around together. So we had to get that in. About a month later, they were in a little school bus. That's what happened. We did a banquet, and we raised $23,500. And they use it all winter and the whole deal. And I don't know if they still use it or not. But every minor league, it was just great. And Swift Current people, they're the best.
8 Broncos in the NHL right now. Here's Riley Nash, guy you caught your eye this week.
Now, Riley Nash, the Boston Bruins. Watch this here, guy. He is something. Watch this here. No, I got to say something about the Bruins. Believe it or not, there's nobody in the top 38. Think about that in the scoring. Look at this guy. Nobody, boom, he puts it in. Nobody in the top 38 in the scoring. That's unbelievable. And here he is there, Riley Nash, good boy from Calgary. I think he is Calgary. He's that. But anyhow, that's a team. Cassidy's got him playing like a team.
When you had the 11, 20 goal scorers, did you have one in the top 5 or 10?
I think McNabb had 43 goals. He was up there. But we didn't have many. Not like, don't compare to my club. No. We lost 18 games all year. We had 11, 20 or more. I think McNabb, I think he was in the top. Anyhow,
this compares to your club for sure. Matty Tkachuk and Ryan Kesler.
Now, look at this here. I've given it to Chuck pretty soon, but watch him with Kessler here at the end. Kessler's a pretty good guy. Give him a little shot here. Like, you want to go, and he's not using these. And this is a beauty. And Kessler can throw him pretty good. Now, watch, he gets the helmet off. That's the best thing to do, get the helmet off. Now, they throw him pretty good. Now, watch the guys banging the boards. The only reason they bang the boards anymore is a fight. The only thing, not goals. Now, I'm going to show you something, folks. Watch this in slow motion. You think that Tkachuk watched his mouth guard? Watch, he's boom, right off like that. Tough guy, I'm giving him heck. And he's just like his old man, boy, standing there, just like his old man.
Speaking of that, Max Domi.
Didn't get this in. You're going to see a Bobby Orr move. Watch this Bobby Orr move. And Max, like this, not nice. Oh, do that again in slow motion. I don't know whether you're going to do it. And that's the winner in overtime. I hope we do it. You got a close-up. Now watch this move. I used to see this every night with Bobby. Go like that, put it between the guy's legs. It was magic. I put it over like that, like I said, and post it over. It's a good friend of mine, Ty, and that's why I got that in here.
Oh, he was so great in the World Juniors. So the game yesterday in Buffalo, Don, I want to ask you, first of all, how you felt about them playing a game in the World Juniors outdoors. What did you think of that?
A lot of snow. It wasn't very good, but it was for both teams, so that's no excuse. There was something funny in the boards, too. I don't know what they did with those boards.
In
those corners, something like funny. Anyhow, no excuses, but we lead the tournament again in penalties. We got to stop getting stupid penalties. Now, he got sucked in here. Watch this, Lindgren. The kid's pretty smart here. He knew what he was doing. He sees him coming. He jumps into the board. He lays there. Now, it looks like a five-minute major. He's all right. He gets up laughing. I'm not knocking the kid. I mean, I wouldn't do it or anything, but he gets up, and he's laughing. And see, what he should have done, he should have bear hugged. They were up 3-1 at the time.
Right.
He should have bear hugged them going in. You got to stop this. You got to can't play Canadian hockey. You're going to have to play European hockey, and you'll win it. That game doesn't mean anything. Play it smart. Don't get dumb penalties.
Outdoors, I worry that they get so disoriented, right? The optics are all crazy because of the football. No, I just say Comtois doesn't know. No, I realize that. But when you're going to take a guy into the boards and it's all a whiteout.
He saw it. The kid, if we showed it again, watch. Can we show that again?
Sure.
I know we don't have much time, but can we show it? Watch the kid glance over his shoulder and see him coming. Watch, see? He knows he's coming. I knew he's going, and he just pushed him. He called it boarding.
Yeah, right.
Smart. You can't play Canadian hockey. You can't be dumb. That's the way. Now, this afternoon, we got
good.
Spengler Cup boy. That's hockey. Those guys out there. There's Willie. He's going again. He's got a Dave King, Scott Walker, tough guy, too. Craig Wedgecraft coming over by. They're good coaches, and, you know, these guys play the game the way the American hockey players used to play. Watch this save, Poulin make. Quebec boy, they win this game. I tell you, I was so excited. This is a great game. And watch this here. Watch this. And beautiful, and makes it like that. And watch the reaction. That was a big goal if he had to score that goal. Was that ever a beauty? And they tap one another, go by. That was great hockey, boy. I hope Hockey Canada doesn't screw it up. Those guys, I'd love to see that team stay together. And Willie's doing a good job. And you and I are going to be doing it. And
the Olympics, yes.
And don't forget, everybody's knocking. We don't have a chance. I'm telling you, we'll be in there. We'll be knocking at the door. I guarantee it.
Time only comes to life when you stop counting it, like the timeless Don Cherry. Happy New Year on the Coach's Corner on Hockey Night in Canada.